Still on the feed mill engine. Now, feed is the mixing here, right? All the formula shown in the previous videos have been mixing here now. The next thing is, if you look at the grains, the grains are still big. So the next thing is to turn it into powder. The first is to amamil it, and then if there's need, when it's going to do an extruding job, then there'll be need for it to be pulverized. But for now, let's just do the hammer mill first to get into powder. So they're going to get into action now. So I don't have to shout. Just watch your action. Now, hold on. This is using a self-priming petrol engine for those who's farm in the local environment. But I think it's even an ideal one, rather than everything petrol. And then you look at, there's supposed to be a cover here, but it's just being removed now. So for safety, that kind of thing. This is 120 kg per hour, but you can order for 240 kg per hour or multiples like that. So let's get cracking. I think we need air boards occasionally when it comes to feed mill business, you know. For those of us who are innovators, it's not the best of environment to be, but I gotta be there just for your sake. Now, this is just demonstrating how a hammer mill press works, right? This is going to release the food ingredients into the place. If you look at what we got here, it's still the ungrounded stuff. And what we have here, you see, almost fine. But we'll still go over there to the pulverizer and see a little bit of difference in the thing. It's a simple machine that you can run on your own, and you can actually move the machine. You know, move it. Okay, thanks. I think it's just outrageous. I'll suggest, except the farming is doing it, you can now ask for maybe 240 kg per hour or thereabout, kind of. But swamp and standard, it's okay. You can have a size farm. So you grind your food into what's it called, and then move on. So if you want it finer for the extra level, you're going to move on to the next machine, which is the polarizer. Okay?